Hi there. So today I want to talk to you about, can stress cause hypoglycemia? I get that question a lot. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja. And today I want to talk to you whether or not stress can cause hypoglycemia. So the first thing I want to answer is, what is hypoglycemia? So by definition, hypoglycemia is when your blood sugar goes too low, and this has to be measured. So 70 milligrams per deciliter or less is considered hypoglycemic. How would we know if we had hypoglycemia? So the typical symptoms are going to be shaky, lightheaded, jittery, can't focus, maybe having a thermal effect, getting shivers, lots of brain fog, and ultimately you're not getting enough energy into the cells, your glucose levels are falling. However, what I would tell people is what you feel in terms of, I feel lightheaded, I feel shaky, I feel jittery, I feel brain foggy, can in fact be hypoglycemia. However, what I would say is you need to test it. So what I do with all my coaching clients is we use the glucose meter, the ketone meter, we use Keto Mojo, and what we do is we take our glucose levels when we think we're hypoglycemic, and we actually measure, we're not guessing. So we wanna see, is our glucose levels less than 70 milligrams per deciliter? However, if it is, I want you to pump the brakes and tell yourself you may not be hypoglycemic yet. The reason you may not be is because if you're metabolically flexible, what is happening is your body is producing ketones. So even though your glucose levels are low or lower than 70, you may still be getting energy into the cell. So hypoglycemia, you're getting your glucose levels low inside the blood. But the point is, inside the cell, you're burning fuel in the way of ketones. So it's really important that you actually test. Because if you just assume, I feel shaky, I feel lightheaded, I feel jittery, chances are you could have some really bad insulin resistance and you've been stressed out a lot. And that's the question we're answering. Can stress cause this problem? So think about what stress does. Stress first causes a cortisol release. The brain signals to the adrenals, and the adrenals produce cortisol and all the other stress hormones that are known to break down glucose and give you instant energy. So it does create increased blood sugar. But over time, if you're constantly doing that and then releasing insulin and then taking glucose out of the blood, you could have hypoglycemia. So stress could cause hypoglycemia. But what I think is really happening is that dancing around of insulin and cortisol, repeated stress, repeated inflammation, repeated life, what happens is ultimately the relationship between cortisol and insulin dances around to the point where you develop insulin resistance, you're not getting glucose out of the bloodstream, you feel hypoglycemic, but when you actually take your glucose levels, you find that your glucose levels are high. And you still have these hypoglycemic tendencies. And it really frustrates a doctor like myself, because I talk to a lot of people and they say, yeah, I'm hypoglycemic. And then I ask them, well, are you measuring your glucose? No, I'm not. Or I went to the doctors, I had an 8-hour fast and my glucose levels were low. But we want to know your real-time glucose levels. What is it when you first wake up? What is it 2 hours later? What is it in the middle afternoon? What is it before bedtime? If your glucose levels are constantly below 70, you're probably hypoglycemic. However, if you measure your ketones and you find that they're above 0.5 millimoles, you're in ketosis and you're starting to sniff the idea of burning ketones as a fuel source, you're not going to have a low amount of energy. So what I want you to do is realize stress, when it's done repeatedly, will cause cortisol and insulin to dance around to the point where it may cause hypoglycemia. The only way you're gonna know for sure is if you actually test using a Keto Mojo. So check below the link and you can purchase one. If your ketones are greater than 0.5 and you're less than 60 and you fasted, you are getting into that metabolically flexible zone of being able to burn energy without relying on glucose. And ultimately, you want to make sure you control your stressors. You have steady flow of energy, whether it's ketones or glucose or protein, that's circulating in your body and feeding your fuel and giving you energy, so that you're not doing that roller coaster ride of hypoglycemia, hyperglycemia, hypoglycemia, hyperglycemia. You want to eat a nice, healthy protein, carbs, and fats. And you want to make sure that you are getting active, because the best thing to help with insulin resistance is movement, is activity, is nourishment. So anyways, I hope you found that was really helpful. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja, and I look forward to ending your adrenal fatigue nightmare.